Hi, this is Rafael Sales. I'm a soft tissue knee surgeon working in Reytington Hospital. In this presentation, I'm going to show the anatomical references that I use for the assessment of trochlea dysplasia. For this purpose, we split the screen into viewing windows. On the left side, we will display the T1 sagittal sequence images. On the right side of the screen, we will display the T2 axial views or transverse cuts of the knee. The next step is to enable the cut lines on both viewing windows. This is represented here by the yellow lines. These cut lines allow us to cross-reference the images on one side of the screen with the corresponding slice on the other part of the screen. The first structure we want to identify is the lateral femoral condyle. We know this is the lateral femoral condyle because we can see the fibular head, the popliteal tendon, and the lateral meniscus, all of which are lateral structures. In the sagittal views, I like to see the full profile of the lateral femoral condyle. We define the posterior femoral condyle line, which is represented here by the red line, as a horizontal line which is just above the cartilage of the posterior femoral condyle. The next step is to bring the yellow cut line on the sagittal views to the level of the posterior femoral condyle line. The trochlear specific zone 0 is localized above the posterior femoral condyle line. The second important reference line is the femoral insertion of the anterior cruciate ligament or proximal Blumenthal line. In order to find this line in the sagittal views, we need to scroll down until we see the trajectory of the fibers of the anterior cruciate ligament, which run parallel to Blumenthal line. We use three anatomical references in the sagittal view to identify the level of the femoral insertion of the anterior cruciate ligament or proximal Blumenthal line. The first reference is the most proximal aspect of the femoral insertion of the anterior cruciate ligament. The second reference is the most proximal aspect of Blumenthal line. And the third reference is the scar of the distal femoral physis, which runs roughly parallel and at the same level as the femoral insertion of the anterior cruciate ligament line. We will use these reference lines to consistently measure, always at the same anatomical level, the different variables used to assess trochlea dysplasia. Here, we are measuring the sulcus angle at the level of the posterior femoral condyle line. In conclusion, we use two simple reference lines, the posterior femoral condyle line and the femoral insertion of the anterior cruciate ligament, to assess the shape of the trochlea. These two lines define two trochlear specific zones. Trochlear specific zone 0 is above the posterior femoral condyle line. Trochlear specific zone 1 is between the posterior femoral condyle line and the femoral insertion of the anterior cruciate ligament line. Thank you for watching this video.